This semester, I spend my internships at two schools in Pflugerville ISD. I started in September at Pflugerville High School working with a teacher of 25 years named Nancy Rousseau. I was really excited to start working at the high school. I couldn't wait to see what the building looked like and what the art room looked like and who the teacher was. And when I got there, I was surprised because everything about this school reminded me of my high school experience. The mascot was the same, the cheerleaders were the same, the colors were the same, everything was just exactly like my high school. When I finally started looking for the classroom, I realized how giant this building was. I didn't know where I was going. I didn't know how I would find the art room. All I had was a room number. So I started walking around and I asked a student to help me find the room. The students were nice and they all helped me get to my room, but I realized they probably thought I was a new student and not a student teacher. It was a good thing I had that ID badge. I finally made it to the classroom, and I was really excited. Except, when I walked in, I was kind of sad because there wasn't really that much art decorating the walls, and there were a lot of desks shoved in this tiny room. But then, I met Nancy, and she told me all about her class. She told me that she had been a teacher for 25 years. She told me that it wasn't really her plan in the beginning, but it just kind of worked out that way. This was her last year as a teacher, but she was pretty excited to have a student teacher this time around. Each lesson began with a 10-minute practice or warm-up type activity, where the students followed along as Ms. Rousseau used a camera and a projector to draw simple images. The activities were something all of the classes did, and the students really enjoyed this part of the day. They learned how to draw something quickly and felt really accomplished afterwards. During our time together, Ms. Rousseau gave me a lot of advice, but probably the most important advice that I'll take with me forever is to make sure that you always respect your students. She told me that she understood the students had a lot of work on their plate. They had a lot of homework, a lot of tests, they had 8 classes and each of them was an hour and a half long. She told me that sometimes they would come to her and tell her that they had a lot of homework the night before and they weren't able to finish their assignment, or that they needed to study for a test that they had in the next class. She told me that sometimes when they come to her with these problems, she lets them study or finish other assignments in class. While I don't know if I'll let students complete other work during my class, I really admire the respect she had for her students. I started at my second internship in the middle of October, working at River Oaks Elementary with Misty Shotlow. My first day there, Misty told me to meet her in the gym. All the kindergarten classes would be there because their teachers were having a meeting every Friday morning at this time. When I got there, I didn't know what to expect, but all the kids were doing yoga. I couldn't get over this. It was just about the cutest thing I'd ever seen, and it was really cool to see an alternative form of physical activity going on in a classroom. I also was really excited to see technology. They were projecting this yoga video onto the wall from YouTube, and all the kids would follow along. It was pretty exciting because they could access all kinds of different yoga videos or dance videos, and the kids could choose which one they wanted to do. They were all really excited about this, and they totally loved it. Then Misty showed me to a classroom, and I was really excited to get there because when I got inside, I noticed that everything was completely organized, labeled, color-coded, you name it, she had done it. The first thing I noticed when I walked into Misty's classroom was that her lesson plan was front and center on the chalkboard. The chalkboard was divided into different sections for each grade, and each section had the completed assignment along with in-progress works that the students could look at. Later, I would see that the students really used these to help finish up their work. I also noticed that Misty had color-coded each table. She told me that each table had its own color, and she used this when assessing behavior and awarding stars at the end of each class. She also used this to help keep track of materials. For example, she had a different set of markers for each table that she kept in separate cups. Each cup would be a color that corresponded to a color on the table. The students who sat at the yellow table, for example, would know that they were responsible for picking up, using, and cleaning up the markers that belonged in the yellow cup. This really helped the students maintain a clean working environment, and they really loved to help. If there was one thing I loved about Missy's organization, it was her planner. Inside her planner, she kept daily notes about what each class had done. She noted what she expected the students to do that day in class, and after each class, she would make a tiny post-it note that said what had actually happened. Like, the schedule might say she expected the first graders to need another class day to complete the painting, but after class, she noted, "Today, first grade, completed paintings, began drawings." For my art criticism activity, I decided to play a game with some of the third grade students. I found a game that was invented in the 1940s by surrealist painters and their salons. The game is called Exquisite Corpse, and it involves collaborative learning. Each student is given a sheet of paper that is folded into thirds. The students start on the first section and are asked to draw a head and not show it to any of the other students. The students then pass their papers after folding away their drawing to their neighbor, and in the second section, they draw a body. After three go-arounds, each student has their own drawing or exquisite corpse. The students thought this game was hilarious. They did not stop laughing, and everyone thought that they just had the craziest drawing they'd ever seen. I wish I had something to show you, but the students ended up taking them all home. I really enjoyed my time in Pflugerville ISD, and I know that the experiences I had there will definitely help me during student teaching next semester.